Hey, what's going on YouTube? I have a new video. It's another collection video that I have that I thought I would make. So it's gonna be my my GameCube collection that I have so far. So I'm just gonna show you each game that I have and if and tell you if I've played them before or not. So I'm gonna start off with the first game right here. The first game is Dragon Ball Z Budokai. You know, I like Dragon Ball Z, so I thought I would play this game. It's basically like you go through like some of the scenes from Dragon Ball Z, you fight some of the characters and stuff. The graphics they're alright, they're not the best graphics. But they're not, I don't think they're the worst, so. And then another game, it's Beautiful Joe. I heard this game is pretty good, so I haven't played it myself, but I heard that it's a really good game, so I'll have to give it a try. And then the other game I have is the official X-Men game. Never played this game. I just picked it up with a GameCube lot. I bought a GameCube lot for like $15, and it came with a couple of good games, and that was one of them. The other game I have is this is the Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. I also got this with that GameCube lot, and actually I played this game so I could test out the Donkey Kong Jungle Beats over there that I got for free at a yard sale. And it's actually a really fun game. I was actually playing it for like a little while, and it was pretty fun. I got to fight this gorilla. You kind of have to box him and you got to fight him. It's pretty fun. The controllers are kind of fun. And next we have Paper Mario. I heard this is a really good game as well. I haven't played it yet, but I'm gonna get to it pretty soon. I got that one at a yard sale. It was like $5 or so. And the next game I have, is Star Fox Adventures. I got this game with the GameCube lot. I got everything for $15. This was one of them, and I heard it's a good game. It's not a good Star Fox game, but it's a good game overall. And another game I got with the GameCube lot was Ultimate Spider-Man. I also got this with that lot, and I never played it, but it looks fun. The graphics look cool, so I'll give it a try. I don't have many GameCube games, but I'm trying to get most of the ones that I had when I bought my GameCube, or when they bought me my GameCube. And there's still some that I'm missing, but I have most of them. I also have a lot that I didn't have, so it's pretty cool. And another game is a Namco Museum. I got this at a yard sale a long time ago. I kind of like this compilation games, So I'm gonna give this one a try. So another game is SX3. Got this at a yard sale. I heard this is a really good snowboarding game. And another game is Soul Calibur 2. I got this at a guy's warehouse. I just ended up finding it, you know, with the whole bunch of other stuff that I bought from the guy. And another game is Metroid Prime. Found this at a yard sale also. Really good game. I played it back in the day. I remember playing it for quite a bit. Need to get back and playing it again. I don't remember nothing about it, but I do remember it was good. I have also Metroid Prime 2. Never played this one, but I found this one before I found Metroid Prime, so I have both of them now. And what else I have here? Okay, I have this. It's pretty cool right here. I have Mega Man Anniversary Collection. This comes with all the Mega Man games. I found this at a yard sale for like $2. It came with this Hollywood video case, but it does have a GameCube case, so that was pretty cool. So I could play all the Mega Man games. And what else we have here? We have Mario Kart. Really good game. I remember playing this with my cousins, fourth player. All four of us, me and my brother, my cousin, and my other cousin, we would all play this game. Really fun game. This one's like the first Mario Kart I ever played. I think I played Mario Kart 64. But this one I play the most, so I had to have this one. And another four-player game or multiplayer game is Super Smash Bros. Melee. I also played this with the same people at the same time. And this was really fun. This one's like, you could play this with friends and just go at it, have a good time, laugh a little bit. All that good stuff. Also have The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. This one I picked up with the GameCube lot for 15. This was the only reason why I picked up the lot for $15. So this one's worth quite a bit. But I ended up selling the GameCube because I already have a GameCube. And I ended up selling it, and so I basically paid nothing for these games. And I ended up, I just kept them for my collection. One of the things about GameCube, I don't know, I just love the GameCube. I think the games look, like, awesome. Like, the games look awesome. Like, the little, like, mini discs, I love those things. They look really cool. I just love collecting them. It was the first system that they ever bought for me. I picked up the GameCube instead of the PlayStation 2, and I remember playing it. I remember I wanted a Grand Theft Auto game because I used to play Grand Theft Auto on the PC, and that game was crazy. I used to be hooked on it. I used to go to these little places back in Mexico where they have computers and you can rent the computers and you could do whatever you want. You could go on the web or you could play games. And I remember they had Grand Theft Auto Vice City, and I was hooked on that thing like nothing else. But we never had Grand Theft Auto on the GameCube, so I mean, I ended up getting the True Crime, The Streets of L.A., which I don't have right now, but, you know, just to throw that on there. But, I mean, nonetheless, this was, like, my favorite, you know, at the time to play and stuff. This was it right here. And I still play it till this day. I play this. And let's see what else we got. things, okay, so we have Burnout 2. This is a really fun game. I heard this is like the best one of the out of the series. So, you know, I tried to play it the other day. It was alright. Maybe I should have played it for a little bit longer. But maybe I'll play it again. So here we go to some of my favorites. This one's Eternal Darkness. Picked up this game. Heard it was a gem, like a must-have. So I picked it up. It's a great game. I can't wait to play it, you know. Especially in this time, this rainy season. Can't wait to play that one. And then we're going to hop over here to my most favorite GameCube games. And this is why you should have a GameCube. Because it gets no better than this. I mean, I'm a Resident Evil fan. And this is why I love the GameCube. I mean, I got all... When they bought me my first GameCube, back when I lived in Mexico, I told my mom, I was like, you know what, I want Resident Evil games. Buy me some Resident Evil games, because she used to live back in the United States. She used to live in the United States, because she was fixing papers for us so we could come over here and live over here. So we had to stay back over there, you know, waiting for us to be, like, legally, so we could be legal, so we could move out here. And I was like, you need to get me some Resident Evil games, because I love playing those games. So, but I didn't know, though. Back in the day, I didn't know nothing about games. So she ended up getting three Resident Evil games. And one of them she got for me was Resident Evil. This was the remake. This is one of my favorite games. I remember playing this when I was like 12 years old or 11 years old, playing this game, actually going through the game. I didn't know, like, no English. I didn't know English, so, like, basically I was just going through, like, the game without reading anything, just trying to figure out, you know, what the hell was going on. And I love how they come with, like, two CDs in it. Like, man, I think they're just really cool. And another one that she got for me was this Resident Evil 4. This one she got for me as well. And I beat this game. I completed this game. I beat this game. I don't even remember, but I do remember some things about it. But I know I beat this game for sure. I went through it I went through it. Like, I played through it. Never got bored. That one game is fun game right there. You gotta play that game. And I gotta have it on the GameCube, because that's the original. That's where it came out. That's where it should have stayed. And you know, I don't think there's a best, you know, version out there. And another one that she got for me was Resident Evil Code Veronica. This one I remember playing. This game is fucking hard, dude. Me and my friend had this game. We both had this game. He had it. That's the reason why I got it, because he had it for the PlayStation 2, and I didn't have a console at the time. But I told my mom, I was like, buy me this game. And she got me this. When I got it, I started playing it, and me and my friend, we were competing, like, to see who beat it, you know, who was the first one to beat it. And I remember catching up. I catched up to him, and I told him, you know, like, I'm on this level, like, where are you at? But yeah, like, this one, man, I didn't beat this game. I think I got to, like, the second city, but that's about it. And then some Resident Evil games that I didn't own. Oh no, never mind. This one I did own. This is Resident Evil Zero. Also owned this game. I didn't beat this game. I got to the second city. But, you know, I own it now. So I'm going to get back to it and play it. I have played it a couple times, but I haven't gone past where I got back in the day. So still need to get that one, you know, another chance. So last two I have Resident Evil 2. This one I didn't have back in the days, but you know, I hear it's like the best Resident Evil game, so I gotta play this one for sure. I'm playing Resident Evil Remake right now, but after that, I'm gonna play this one and see how it goes. Another one I have, Resident Evil 3. This one is another good one right here. I've played it a little bit, but never beat it. So I need to start playing this. I'm thinking of playing all of them, you know, like since Resident Evil 0 and Resident Evil 1. 2, 3, and so on. So I think those are all my GameCube games that I have so far, starting with some of my favorites right there, and so on. There you go, some PlayStation games, you know, I was as well. But yeah, man, I mean, pretty happy with what I got right now. I'm still missing some of my favorite ones that I used to play back in the day, like Need for Speed Underground and Need for Speed Underground 2, and I'm also missing Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3 and 4. Those are like those games I played the most. Like, I used to tell my cousins, "Hey, what game you want to play?" And I would be like, "Yeah, put Tony Hawk game," because I don't know, I just thought it was freaking cool. And I remember I used to want to play that over like Smash Brothers and Mario Kart. So I gotta have that game. I also remember playing that True Crime, and what else? And I think that's about it. So I mean, I'm not so far from reaching my goal. So you know, wait for another video. I'll be making another video of my PlayStation 3 collection. I love my PS3. I have lots of games for it. It's the system that got me into like hardcore gaming and got me into collecting, and it's the one that I've had the most hours, you know, playing games for. So PS3 collection coming soon. You gotta watch that video. I have a lot of games, a lot of really good games, and you know, stay tuned for that. So thank you guys, and watch this video and like and let me know what you think of my GameCube collection.